You are the face of God. I hold you in my heart. You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God. I hold you in my heart. You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God.
Tu es l'image de Dieu.
I hold you in my heart.
Tu es l'image de l'amour.
You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God.
Tu sei la luce di Dio.
I hold you in my heart.
Tu sei il volto dell'amore.
You are a part. You are the face of God. You are the face of
love. You are the face of love.
I hold you in my heart.
I hold you in my heart.
You are my family.
You are my family.
You are the face.
You are the face of love.
You are the face
you
of love. You are the face of God,
the face of God.
I hold you in my heart,
I hold you in my heart.
You are a part of me,
a part of me.
You are the face of
God, the face of God.
You are the face of God.
Eres la luz de Dios.
I hold you. You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God. You are the face of God. You are the face.
Tu sei la luce di Dio.
You are the face.
You are the face of God.
You are the face.
Tu es l'image de Dieu.
You are the face.
You are the face of God.
You are the face.
Tu sei la luce di Dio.
You are the face.
You are. Face of God,
you are the face of God. You are the face.
You are the face of God.
You are the face. You are the face of God. I hold you in my heart. You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God. I hold you in my heart. You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God.
Tu es l'image de Dieu.
I hold you in my heart.
Tu es l'image de l'amour.
You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God.
Tu sei la luce di Dio.
I hold you in my.
Sei il volto dell'amore.
You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face
you
of love.
You are the face of love.
I hold you in my heart.
I hold you in my heart.
You are my family.
You are my family.
You are the face
you
of.
Of God,
you are
the face of God.
I hold you in my heart.
I hold you in my heart.
You are a part of me.
A part of me.
You are the face of
you
God.
The face of God.
You are the face of God.
Eres la luz de Dios.
I hold you. You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God. You are the face of God. You are the face
tu sei la luce di Dio.
You are the face
you are of God. The face of God.
You are the face
tu es l'image de Dieu.
You are the face
you
of God.
Are the face of God.
You are the face
tu
of
sei
God.
La luce di Dio.
You are the face
you
of God.
Are face of God,
you are the face of God. You are the face.
You are the face of God.
You are the face of God.
Good morning, and welcome to Spiritual Life Center, a church that love is building.
Holy, the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel God's mighty power and God's grace. I can hear the brush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place.
On this second Sunday of Advent, we focus on the blessing of peace. Dear God, we come together in praise and celebration of you. We know with absolute certainty that your kingdom reigns, and we ask that you open our hearts and minds to know you, to embrace your peace, and to serve you. Your servant Jesus Christ made clear that thereby we shall come to experience your kingdom here on earth. For this and every blessing you shower upon us, we say thank you, God, in the name and through the power and in the nature of the Christ Spirit that lives within each one of us. And so it is. Amen.
I wish you peace when the cold winds blow, warmed by the fire's glow. I wish you comfort in the lonely time, and arms to hold you when you ache inside. I wish you hope when things are going bad, kind words when times are sad. I wish you shelter from the raging wind, cool waters at the fever's end. I wish you peace when times are hard, a light to guide you through the dark, and when storms are high and your dreams are low, I wish you the strength to let love grow. I wish you the strength to let love flow. I wish you peace when times are hard, a light to guide you through the dark, and when storms are high and your dreams are low, I wish you strength to let love grow. I wish you strength to let love flow. I wish you the strength to let love glow. I wish you the strength to let love go.
This week that we focus on peace, I know each one of us feel in our heart the need for something quiet, something peaceful, something loving. And so we turn to God and ask for those things in our life. And when we think about what peace would mean to us, it would mean the most if we were at one with God. Can we start all this off on the weekend?
Okay, Nick, Lenore is going to start over again at this point. Take it just a minute and then start.
This week we focus on peace and what peace means to us in our life and how do we reach that peace that we want to have more of. And there's one way that we can, and that is to become more at one with our God the Father. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. I have called you by name, and you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God. You are precious in my sight and honored, and I love you. Dear God, create in me this day a desire to be a new person, to recreate myself, to be more of you. On this day, let me seek out a forgotten friend to end a quarrel, to replace suspicion with trust. Inspire me this day to write a love letter or share some treasure, to give you a soft answer instead of a hard response. Change my heart, O God. Make me more like you. By my actions, help me today to encourage another person to manifest loyalty in word and deed, to keep their promises. Help me find the time to help another and give the gift of forgiving a grudge. Help me, dear God, to forgive a wrong, to be a better listener. Give me the words to apologize if I'm wrong, so I can try to understand others. Let me look at myself with a new clarity as I enter the time of solitude in the silence. And let me heal the broken places as I rest with you in the silence. As I prepare to go back into my day, help me, dear God, to appreciate everything and everyone around me. Help me to be kind, to be gentle, to laugh a little more, that I can step out of any complacency and freely express my gratitude and joy. Help me to remember to go to you, dear God, in prayer each day, so I can know your divine love and to manifest your divine love. Out of strength I received during my time of prayer and contemplation. Divine love, manifest yourself in me. The true Church of Christ is inside of me, so that wherever I go, I will be God's love in action. I will be kind to strangers. I will gladden the hearts of others. Help me wherever I go to show my love, to speak it, and to live it. These are simple things, but as I meditate on them in prayer, I realize that their powerful influence in my life and the life of others, that love is the truest celebration of life. There is a sudden stirring in my heart, and I hear the wild, sweet music of angel choirs. I pray as I realize that what is going on inside of myself, that I can take action to love my world and everyone in it. And now let us join together as we sing and pray the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will
as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory.
Now I've been happy lately, thinking about the good things to come, and I believe it could be something good has begun. Oh, I've been smiling lately, dreaming about the world as one, and I believe it could be something good is going to come. 'Cause out on the edge of darkness, there rides a peace train. Oh, peace train, take this country, come take me home again. Now I've been smiling lately, thinking about the good things to come, and I believe it could be something good has begun. Oh, peace train sounding louder, reside on the peace train. Oh, come on, come on now, come on, peace train. Yes, peace train, holy roller, would everyone jump on the peace train? Oh, come on, come on now, come on, peace train. Get your bags together, go bring your good friends too. Our cause is getting nearer, it soon will be with you. And come and join the living, it's not so far from you. And it's getting nearer, soon it will all be true. Oh, peace train sounding louder, everyone reside on the peace train. Come on, come on. Come on now, come on, peace train. Now I've been crying lately, thinking about the world as it is. Why must we go on hating? Why can't we live in bliss? 'Cause out on the edge of darkness, there rides a peace train. Oh, peace train, take this country, come take me home again. Oh, peace train sounding louder, reside on the peace train. Oh, come on, come on now, come on, peace train. Yes, peace train, holy roller, would everyone jump on the peace train? Oh, come on, come on now, come on, peace train. Yes, come on, come on now, come on, peace train.
Namaste, friends. Peace, peace. May all beings be at peace. May all beings be at peace. What does peace mean to you? Is it natural to have peace, or more natural to have anxiety? How many times have we prayed for peace in a family, or peace in our own mind, peace in our heart, peace in the world? Peace, peace, peace. One of the fun things we do with my family at Christmas is to put, I put money down in plain white envelopes and put a word on the outside of the envelope, like peace, hope, faith, joy, love, gratitude. And I asked them to pick an envelope that is like their white stone word. What is it they're going to intend for this year, for this holiday season or this year? And throughout my life of doing this, which has been several in my adult life, my dad always dug through the envelopes to find the one that said peace. He wanted peace. I think peace of mind. He didn't talk about world peace or the unrest in the world. He talked about wanting inner peace. So then in the envelope is money. So we open the envelopes and there's bills, money, currency in there. And so it's like, oh, I got a gift here. I've got money here. And then the money ranges from $1 to $100 bill. So somebody got the least and somebody got the most. And then just as we start celebrating who got the most, I let them know that it's not theirs to keep. That the money that they have been given is to be given. So what happens to our peace then? So can I still have peace and gratitude and joy and love and whatever I picked on my envelope when I don't get to keep the money? When I'm asked to turn right around and give the money away or to give the money back? What would happen to your peace if you were handed a $100 bill, for example, and then said, oh, by the way, it's not for you. It's to pass on. It's to give. Is peace possible? Is peace actually ever attainable? So what would it be like to be at peace regardless of what happened, to be at peace whether we got the $1 bill or the $100 bill, to be at peace, to be at peace if it's given, to be at peace if it is taken, to be at peace if it's coming in, to be at peace if it's going out. What would that be like? I got a powerful poem as I was thinking about peace, the messages of peace, and my devotion to this. And I have to be careful not to pretend I'm at peace when my guts are really twisted versus I'm at peace sometimes, and at times I'm disturbed. At times I'm at peace, and at times I'm in anxiety. And friends, the only person that's free of anxiety, totally free of anxiety, are dead people. So as long as we're alive, we're going to have moments of non-peace. And what if we could be at peace at not having peace? I can be more at peace even when I'm not in peace. Imagine. Then I accept there'll be times of unpeace. I accept there'll be times of disturbance, of irritations, frustrations. And just beyond that is a field, an atmosphere of peace available to me, even when it doesn't go my way. Is this the time? Is this season of Advent the time? As we're awakened, born into a higher expression of Christ consciousness, Can it be now? So the poem is called A Peace Prayer. So as I present it here, I'm going to do it in a spirit of prayer and of believing prayer has power. So I'd encourage you to join me in this or to re-listen to this if it's meaningful to you and to speak it in your own way and in your own words, from your own heart, from your own inspired uplift as we awaken to what we can actually do something about. I cannot make the world peaceful. I can't stall tanks from roaring down roads. I can't prevent children from having to hide in bunkers. I cannot convince the news to stop turning war into a video game. I can't. I can't silence the sound of bombs tearing neighborhoods apart. I can't turn a guided missile into a bouquet of flowers. I can't make a warmonger have an ounce of empathy. I can't. I can't convince ambassadors to quit playing truth or dare. I can't deflect a sniper's bullet from turning a wife into a widow. I can't stave off a country being reduced to ash and rubble. I can't. I can't do any of that. What can I do? What will I do? What will you do? The only thing I can do is love the next person I encounter without any conditions or strings. I can do that. I can do some of that. I can do better at that. The things I can do, will do, is to love my neighbor so fearlessly that it starts a ripple that stretches from one horizon to the next. I can do that. To love my neighbor so fearlessly that it starts a ripple that stretches from one horizon to the next. I can't force peace on the world, but I can become a force of peace in the world. Sometimes all it takes is a single lit candle in the darkness. A single lit candle in the darkness. Sometimes that's all it takes to start a movement. To start a movement of peace. Sometimes all it takes is a single lit candle in the darkness. To become a force of peace in the world. To love our neighbors so fearlessly that it starts a ripple that stretches from one horizon to the next. To love the next person I encounter with less conditions, less strings. Lord, make me a candle of comfort in this world God, make us a candle of comfort in this world. Let me burn with peace. Let us burn with peace. Amen. So be it. So, how? Now what? Who can you extend your deeper peace to? How can we mend the breach between the world as it is as power and the world as it can be as peace? Both love and power are necessary building blocks for God's peaceful realm on this earth. Love utterly redefines the nature of power. Power without love is mere brutality, even in our ministries. And love without power is only the sentimentality of an individual lives disconnected from the whole. So the Gospels have told us in its fullness holds love and power together, and together creates hope and healing for the world. Peace for the world. Power assumes that life is lived from the top down and from the outside in, and that it draws strength from elites or enforcements. The gospel offers us the inefficient, not so clean, multi-layered, long hallway of love. And love is lived much more from the bottom up and from the inside out. And so is peace. So can we use our holy discontent as we claim and pray for and desire a world at peace to do our own spiritual work? And to know that trying to get the external to change, to try to get the external to be at peace when I am not at peace is pure insanity. So what can you do today? Can you do this week, this month? So imagine you're taking a walk and there's a piece of paper on the side of the road and you lose your peace. And we can pick that piece of paper up out of indignation, righteousness. I have to pick it up, or I'm supposed to pick it up. Or I can pick it up simply as an artist making the world more beautiful out of my own integrity. And my mind doesn't have to say, I'll pick this one up, but I'm not going to pick up every single piece of litter I see. Nor does our mind have to say, what idiot threw this piece of paper down here? This is the kind of person who puts war in the world, more violence in the world. We can live more simply, spontaneously, in harmony with the way things are. I can pick up the piece of paper with less angst. I can pick up the children's socks off the floor with less angst. That means that I will expect nothing back from my actions because they were not done for approval or appreciation or recognition. So freer of seeking, I will have greater peace. The hell is in the seeking. The disharmony is in the seeking. So with less seeking, I can't help but to share a more radiant, beautiful energy that's going on inside of me than that is like a beacon of light for the world, for others, for people, for the next person I encounter. The highest life I can live is when every single moment that passes before me is better off because of the way I related to it. So serving the present moment with all of my heart and soul, regardless of what the moment is. Imagine what the world would be like if everyone did that. Start a movement of peace. Start a movement of harmony. Shall we? By raising whatever appears before you, and me raising whatever appears before me, if I can't even serve what is put in front of me, how am I going to change the world? How are you going to change the world if you can't and won't serve what is right in front of you? And if we're going to continue to get upset about conditions in the world, and that I'm then edgy with everyone around me, snarky, snippy, sarcastic, whatever it is, I'm not helping anyone. I'm not creating a world that works for all. I'm not let there be peace on earth and let it begin with me. I'm not that. And if I can't create harmony within myself, within my own household, what right do I have to complain about countries shooting missiles at each other? I don't. So I've got to live that life. I've got to live by my own philosophies instead of dumping my philosophies out on other people or other countries. We have to live a life that if everyone lived it, there would be peace. It actually starts with me. So for me to be part of the solution, I've got to let go of those old parts of myself. Because the world, life as it unfolds, is going to hit all the triggers. Whatever I'm feeling going on inside of me when this happens, this reactive energy, I've got to grow up enough spiritually, emotionally, mature enough around that to not ever act based on that, those triggers. And to accept the responsibility that I am polluting the environment with this pent up, unprocessed, unhealed energy. And good will not come from that. Peace will not come from that. World peace will not come from that. So as we become more conscious, present, paying attention, we know what to do. We know what to do. We know what to choose. The moment is in front of us, right here, right now. It doesn't have to be in words. The piece of paper on the ground, the person who needs some help, whatever it is, our response becomes obvious, clear, thoughtful, intentional. the deepest truth is that it doesn't even matter what we do. What matters is our motive for doing it. And if our motive is to let go of ourselves and serve the moment in front of us, then it is worthy of great respect and a deep, deep abiding peace is the payoff. Spread light. Start a movement of peace. Together we can do what one cannot do alone. I can become a force of peace in the world. I can't force peace on the world. And I can become a force of peace in the world. Sometimes all it takes is a single lit candle to start a movement. Let me burn with peace. God, make me a candle of comfort in this world. God bless you. Let me know how I can support you. ArthurCreek.com. Peace, peace, peace.
Jesus, our Emmanuel.
We are grateful to the group Helix from Dublin, Ireland. And thank you, Nancy Ingalls, for your marvelous singing this morning. Reverend Martha, another powerful message. Thank you so much. We are pleased that each of you could join us for today's service, and we do invite you now to join in our prayer of sharing. Divine love, through me, blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. And we do ask that you support the church with a donation to Spiritual Life Center. There are four ways to do so, at least. First is online through our secure website, www.slctroy.com/give. A second way is mail a check to Spiritual Life Center, 41340 Fox Run Road, number 106, Novi, Michigan, 48377. A third way, call my cell, 248-925-6214. Speak directly with me and provide credit card information for a one-time charge. There is a fourth way, and that is to go to the weekly email that you receive every Friday, and on there in a couple places you'll see donate here or donate online. We welcome anyone. If you're joining us for one of your first times, we invite you to join our email list by visiting our website, www.slctroy.com. And in the upper right corner, you'll see join email list. If you just click on that and insert your name and email address, we'll see that you receive the weekly email every Friday that provides the link to the upcoming Sunday service, as well as a link to any upcoming classes. If you have a prayer request, send these to ronaldfscott@gmail.com, and we will forward these on to our prayer team of now 37 members on the prayer team. It is so powerful. You want them praying on behalf of you and your loved ones, and they're delighted to do so. Next Sunday, on the third Sunday of Advent, Reverend Anita provides us a message of love. The Spiritual Life Center Christmas party will be tonight, Sunday, December 10th. Try to arrive between 4 and 4:30 at the clubhouse of Northfield Hills Condominiums, 1750, that's 1750 Brentwood Drive in Troy. It is exciting that 80 of us are coming together for this special celebration. Call if you have any questions about that. We hope you are able to follow along on the daily messages in the Advent booklet leading to Christmas. Our SLC Christmas Eve service will be online on YouTube at 5 p.m. 2 weeks from today. Immediately following the end of today's service, everyone is invited to join us on Zoom for a time of social connection. The link was in your Friday email. But first, let's join together in our peace song and benediction. God bless.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. With God as Creator, family all are we. Let me walk with my family in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now. With
And now as you go forth, know that the light of God surrounds you, the love of God enfolds you.
The Lord bless thee and keep thee.
The power of God protects you.
The Lord make his face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee.
The presence of God watches over you.
The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and grant thee peace.
Wherever you are, God is.
Amen. Amen.
Go your way rejoicing. All is truly well.